understand his purpose. He neglected and abused his potential, and he lost his pathway. Well, what does all of this mean? Because for my life, I was that dude. I was the prodigal son. I was this cat that didn't know my purpose. I was this cat that was abusing my potential, and I was this cat that was lost. All of those things reflected in drugs and some other stuff in my life, and I know that's not the testimony of everybody, but I think we can all attest, especially as men, that sometimes in life, we lose that glimpse of our purpose. We possibly don't know how to associate or put in right perspective our potential. And more than often, a lot of times, we seem to lose our pathway. And oftentimes, we wake up in the mornings just moving around, wondering what's going to happen next.
Mingo.
But I understand something. That my story is that I gave my heart to Christ. And when I gave my heart to Christ, I had purpose again. One of my favorite scriptures in the whole wide world is Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. And it says this. It says, we are the workmanship of God, created in Christ Jesus, ordained to be have a good work. Works that's been ordained before the foundations of the earth so that we can walk in them and accomplish good things. I didn't know the good that I had to bring to this earth. And I know a lot of times in life, sometimes we don't fully recognize the good that we have to offer. But see, the good that we have to offer can only be found in a relationship with Christ. The second thing that I found about when I gave my life to Christ is that the full potentials, the abilities, the powers, the gifts, the talents, the visions, the emotions, the things that I had on the inside of myself, the things that I knew I could do, when Christ came into my life, he gave reason to it. Part of my testimony is this. When I was there, I had a longing to go to the NFL to be a professional trainer. I tried to be a professional football player, but that didn't work. Because the first day I got out to the football field, I seen this big old 6 foot guy, 250 pounds running to me, running a 440. I was like, y'all can keep that, dog. And I said, that's not for me. So I started going down another track, and I wanted to be a professional trainer in the NFL. Well, the Lord blessed me. And I was able to go and work for the Dallas Cowboys for 2 years as a professional trainer in the NFL, traveling all over the country. But just months before, I was this guy sitting on the back of a toilet seat, smoking dope up my nose. And so my potentials were not really realized. Ended up living my dream because Jesus appropriated and put in right perspective the things that I had in my heart. And the last thing that he did for me is he put me on a pathway. For my life, that pathway has meant a beautiful family. For that life, my pathway has meant money in my pocket, opportunity, business goals, things, enjoying, being here with y'all. Been locked up in and out of jail, but now I'm a free man. Because I had a pathway that I wouldn't have never found if Christ wouldn't have never come into my heart. There's one last thing I want to share with you that I think that changed my life. I love using this analogy of a lighthouse. Everybody know what a lighthouse is? It's on the shore. It's there to guide the ships in. The interesting thing about a lighthouse is this. Is that a lighthouse is positioned on the shore strategically, taller than the horizon, taller than the trees, but it has a bright light on the top. And the thing about it is that it doesn't help the ships if the ships come in really close and then they say, oh, here goes a lighthouse. Maybe too late for them. But the strategy is that the lighthouse is there so that the ships can see it afar off. So that the closer they get, the lighthouse can say two things. Don't go here because there's rocks. Number two, come here and this is the safest passageway. The thing I learned about that is this, fellas and ladies and children, is that I may not ever see you again. I'll probably come back up here and play ball, but I'm not in your life. I'm not in your life every day. I don't know what you do once you leave here. You don't know what I do once I leave here. But I understand in life that sometimes you have moments that I like to call lighthouse moments. Lighthouse moments that may not change your life, but it's a light that goes off to let you know, hey, you know what? I'm either going to a path that's running into some rocks, or this lighthouse is here to show me that I'm on a good path headed to safe harbor. I don't know where you may find yourself tonight. I don't know where you may find yourself in this minute. You may be a ship that doesn't know your purpose, doesn't understand your true potential, and you definitely don't have a pathway. Or you may be a ship that says, you know what? I do have purpose. I do have potential. But I may not know what way I need to put it, which way I need to go. I've been there. We've all been there. But tonight there's a solution. Tonight there's a way for you to look at your life and say, you know what? That guy came and he was a lighthouse. He said something that helped me out. I may not make the decision right here, but I know tonight after I leave here, I'm going to think about my purpose, I'm going to think about my potential, and I'm definitely going to explore the pathways of my life. And one of the things that I like to do is this, is that for your heart to get on that pathway that you may not have known, or walk in that potential that you may not have realized, and definitely understand that purpose that you may not understand or know, it's very simple. And it's a simple prayer of invitation of Christ into your heart. Now I want to do something real fast. I'm not going to put anybody on blast, because when I was here in the same position trying to make a decision for my life, nobody put me on blast. But I understood something, that the moment that I made a decision to let Christ in my heart, it was a moment that changed my life. It wasn't a moment where I became all starchy and religious and all of this stuff and walked on water and, oh, oh, it wasn't like that. But what it was a realization in my heart that I had more to offer, that I had more to bring to the table. So I want you to do something for me right quick. If you can, I want everybody just to close their eyes 1 second. Just close your eyes 1 second. You don't have to worry. I'm not going to sneak up on you, hit you, grab you, pull you by the ear, nothing like that. Close your eyes 1 second. Nobody looking around. If tonight in your heart you feel that, hey, you know what? I want to know my purpose. I don't really understand my potential, and I definitely don't understand my pathway. But brother, I believe some of what you're saying about Jesus can help me understand my purpose, realize my full potential, and put me on the right pathway in life. I just want to see you put your hand up just like that. You don't have to put it up high. You just put it up just like that. Good. I see you. I see you. And if you can do something for me, I'm just asking. I ain't trying to put nobody on blast. Just keep your head down, eyes closed. I see your hands. I see your hands. I see you. Anybody else? Good. Good. I see you. I see you. Great. You can put your hands down. And I want to do like this. I'm not going to put you on blast, but I know, and you know, who you were, who you raised your hands, and what you have going in your heart right now. Now, you may not have made that decision tonight to do that. That's all right. I want to lead you in a prayer, a simple prayer of accepting Christ into your life and believing that when you do this, that he'll come in, show you your purpose, show you your potential, and put you on a pathway that will change your life. And if you raise your hand, and I'm asking everybody, because you may not have raised your hand because you really didn't understand, but I believe that Christ loves you so much that he'll come in and give you an understanding and show you the way that you need to go, because it is his will that every man be saved and come into the knowledge of the truth. He doesn't want anybody to miss it. God ain't mad at you. He's not mad at you and trying to bring you down and do all of this stuff to you. He wants to help you and put your life on a good track. And so we say this, and just repeat after me the best way that you can. Say, Father, I thank you. I believe that Jesus Christ came into the world and died for my sin. I believe that you love me and you're not mad at me. And you're willing to forgive me of all the things that I've done in my life. Jesus, right now, the best that I know, I welcome you into my heart.
I welcome you into my heart.
As my Savior.
As my Savior.
As my Lord.
As my Lord.
And my friend.
And my friend.
Show me my purpose.
Show me my purpose.
Show me my potential.
And put me on my pathway. And put me on my pathway.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I thank you for doing this.
I thank you for doing this.
I give my life to you.
I give my life to you.
Use me.
Use me.
For your service.
For your service.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, if you prayed that prayer, one of the things that's happened in your life is that you've given the Lord rule to reign in your life. One of the things I say with this, brothers, is if you don't go to this church, you know who you were. You know who you raised your hand. You can either come up to me and say, hey, bro, I raised my hand. Tell me a little bit more about this Jesus. You can go to Pastor Scott. He can tell you a little bit more. I encourage you, if not this church, if not somewhere, you get somewhere with somebody's teaching you how to live your life, teaching you how to bring the best out of your life and be the best that you can be. The change that you made in your life tonight is one that will change the rest of your life. It'll change your family. It'll change your God, change your job. It'll change your financial situation, change your life. Brothers and sisters, thank you for listening. Thank you for opening up your heart. I appreciate it. Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Pastor Scott. And bless y'all. God bless y'all.
Thank you. Thank you.